week 8 of the National Football League. And we'll be watching Alex Singleton. He put up numbers last week with a 9-tackle performance. It's the Ravens and the Black Knights, next on EA Sports.
Now from the birthplace of the game itself, EA Sports so proud to join you from the Hall of Fame city of Canton, Ohio. Today we've got a Week 8 matchup on tap here, as it'll be the Baltimore Ravens taking on the Black Knights of Canton. Along with Charles Davis, Brandon Gauden here. And Charles, we take a look at this Canton team as they get ready down on the field.
They can't be any better as we hit the halfway mark. A perfect 7-0 on the year.
And when we looked at this team in August and we looked at the schedule, we thought they had the potential to get off to a hot start. But I don't think either of us expected 7-0.
Meanwhile, for the visiting Ravens, they're in a real groove of late. Winners of... Our scoreless game, well, it may not stay that way much longer as this defense is out there needing a stop on first and goal. A shotgun snap for Smith. To the goal line, but it's incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
To the ground now, it's Henry.
And a nice job to break free of one tackle, but it slowed his momentum somewhat, and he's taken down right after.
Only a yard there, and that'll bring us to third and goal. Here's Smith. And in for the Ravens touchdown. Amari Cooper, his third touchdown now on the year.
And the Ravens are on the board first here this afternoon.
One of the keys to their long winning streak has been scoring first. An ideal drive right there, getting the first 6 points of the ball game.
Do you go back to our meeting with the offensive coordinator?
No. A big early third down here for this defense as they look to hold on and force a field goal try. They'll try to run for it with Barkley. And he will have the first down at about the 21-yard line. It's a gain of 4 there, and it gives him a new set of downs. As we drop you into the action, it's 2nd down, 2nd and 5, inside the red zone. After 1, 7-0 on EA Sports. 2nd quarter down, it's our home team with possession as they are looking at a 2nd and 5 situation. Now they'll throw with Rodgers. Caught by Jones. And stopped a few yards shy of the goal line at the 3. A solid pickup of 13 sets him up 1st and goal. Here's Rodgers. And it's caught. Touchdown. Adam Thielen from 3 yards out. And the Black Knights are an extra point away now from tying this ballgame. And all about timing there on that short slant, Charles.
Exactly right. That was timed up so well. The route, the throw, touchdown.
Red zone update. This defense stacked up here with a 1st and 10 inside the 15. 1st down. Here's the run to Montgomery. This will be stopped about 2 yards shy of the marker. 8-yard gain, 2nd and 2.
That's a strong pickup right there on 1st down. And as this drive goes on, we're seeing an offensive line and running game imposing its will.
They keep it on the ground. This time it's Henry. A 5-yard gain there makes it 1st and goal.
Some good strong running right there. Some power and some explosiveness just about got him into the end zone.
Henry.
And he is met at the line of scrimmage, and he goes down right there. No gain on the play that time, and it sets up second and goal. Keep in mind, if you're thinking of staying on the ground, this is a top five rush defense.
Yeah, but I don't think you shy away totally with the run. At least show them the hint of a run before you decide to throw the football.
Trying to punch it in with Henry. And he'll get in. Touchdown, Baltimore.
Derrick Henry. His eighth rushing touchdown on the year. And the Ravens are able to extend their lead.
You think back to some of the great goal line bruisers of the past, the Earl Campbells, the John Riggins, the Marshawn Lynches. I think you can put Derrick Henry right in that group.
The offense back out there at the line, ready for their next drive. As this offense comes back out here, Charles, they're trailing in this ball game, and they've been on the sideline for a while. They did.
He's got a man complete, and he's taken down right at the 45-yard line. Heck of a start, a 30-yard pickup on their first play from scrimmage.
And that might be exactly what they needed to wake up this home crowd. They haven't given them much to cheer for so far, and never underestimate the effect the home crowd with you can have on a game.
So the big play moves him all the way across midfield. It's first and 10 from the 45. Throwing now is Rodgers. And he goes down. The Ravens able to get to him. And award that sack to Boogie Basham.
Okay, I'm not sure you could actually draw a better pass rush than that one right there. Nowhere to go outside. He had to keep backing up and backing up and backing up. Eventually dropped for a huge loss.
A second down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
Now you and I, partner, we got the plum assignment this week. An unbeaten team against a one-loss team. Really not much separating these two entering play here today.
Not much at all. And I think for both coaches, they looked at their team and said, guys, you got to know what you're getting into in this one. And you better be ready to go because you get to answer the big question of the day. Are we as good as we think we are? We're about to find out.
And how about this? Fourth and long, and they're going to go for it. They'll try and throw for it here. And it's going to be batted down. It will go the other way with a football. Boy, a real head scratcher there. And the Ravens get the football back and in great shape. So they give it up just on their side of midfield. And, yeah, I mean, a surprising decision there to go for that.
Must have a lot of confidence in his defense. Must feel like, hey,
this defense backed up now as they're looking at a first and goal just inside the 10. Here's Smith. A hit as he throws there, incomplete.
I see the surprise in your face there, partner. That is a rare completion from him. He's been on point this entire game.
He has percentage completion-wise way up, not that time.
To the air again, Smith. And he's going to be taken down, sacked back around the 18-yard line. Ravens going to use their third and final timeout as the clock will stop with 21 seconds to go here in the first half. Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And pressure coming, and they got him once again. Leonard Floyd providing a little deja vu. Back-to-back sacks, and now they're staring at a fourth and long. So we have reached halftime here with the visiting Ravens out in front as we are off to Orlando now to check in with Jonathan Coachman and our EA Sports Halftime Report. Coach?
All right, Brandon, thanks very much. Hi again, everybody. Let's get you caught up with what's going on around the league here in the unofficial midway point, week 8 of the NFL season. We'll start up in the...
Well, we'll move right through the break then, skipping halftime and back to the field for the start of the second half.
Welcome back. Charles and I settled into the booth, ready for quarter number 3.
This still a one-possession game, 8 points the difference as we resume action on EA Sports. and makes it across the 20 as his guys will set up shop at the 23. We've got an offense in the red zone, but facing a third down situation here. On third down, Barkley. And he gets the first down yardage before he's brought down just outside the 10 at the 11. A strong 8 yards will keep this drive rolling.
We all love to have a home run hitter in the backfield that can take him the distance. But a short yardage trying to pick up first downs, that big guy, always a nice luxury to have, isn't he?
They keep it with Barkley on first down. And he will maneuver his way down to about the 7. A gain of 3, second down.
I do know from experience that when you slow down someone's running game, you're now doing the dictating on defense. And guess what? Now you're getting ready to tee off on their quarterback because they have to throw it all the time. But you still have to be alert for the draws and other plays of that nature and make sure you don't get hurt.
And he's going to press this one forward as they stop it right around the 1. A gain of 3 last play. This time they double it and pick up 6. Here comes third and about a foot. Again, it's Barkley. And he'll take it into the end zone for a touchdown. Saquon Barkley punching it in from a yard away. And the Black Knights have come back to make it a 2-point game. Well, he finishes off the drive with a touchdown run, Charles. Remember, he also had a catch on this drive as well.
And that's what running backs want to be in today.
Big play coming up for this defensive unit. They're down, but just by a bit on the scoreboard. Can they get this third down stop in the third quarter? Mel Smith. And he'll find the open man. That's complete. And he will have a Ravens first down. They needed 4. He doubled that. He wound up getting 8. This defense in need of a big stop in a tight game in the fourth quarter. Let's see if they can get that stop they need. 13-8. Throwing on third down, Smith. And that's incomplete. So 2 third down conversions on this drive, but not able to get a third, and now they deal with 4th down. The key coming up here, preserve the lead for this defense. 4th quarter, close game. 3rd down, here we go. Throwing is Rodgers on 3rd down. Throw left side on target to Thielen. And this effort will not get it done. He's gotta have this one. Here to the middle of the field, and he's got a man complete. And they will eventually get him down, but he's inside the 5 all the way to the 3. Wow, 1st and goal, and defensively, all they could do is shake their heads. Not only did they allow the conversion, but a big play as well. It's a 3rd down situation in the 4th quarter. Time to see if this defense is up to the task. Back to throw, Smith. They'll set up the screen to Montgomery. And they're able to get this one past the 30, down to the 25.
It's a pickup of 11 and a Baltimore first down.
I like the play design there. They occupy.
On first down, it's Smith.
Oh, this one incomplete. The pressure got to him as he released it. And it's second down.
Smith now to throw. Nowhere to turn here, and he's going to go down. Back at about the 37-yard line. Vinny Curry never giving up. He works his way to the QB for a loss of 12.
Well, many times when you talk about mobile quarterbacks, you get the sense that they feel like they can get out of any bad situation. They keep moving around and trying to emulate guys like the scrambler or the dodger. Instead, they keep losing yardage and losing yardage and digging themselves a hole that they can't get out of.
3 points separating these two sides with 2 minutes left to go in the fourth.
So it's Raven football here as we welcome you back.
This crowd turning up the decibel level. It's third and long.
Now it's Smith. Caught by Montgomery. And he gets it down to the 32. And whistles, and we're going to have another stoppage of play as they call the timeout on defense with 1:53 left. So now one of the biggest kicks of the night is forthcoming. He was true on his first. This is a tough one from 49 yards away.
Gano's kick is good.
And we are all tied here in the final stages.
So he's been automatic to this point of the season, and he connects on the field.
The offense now at the line, ready for their next drive.
A long drive last time out for this offense, Charles. If you remember, they started basically in the shadows of their own end zone, marched it down the field, and a lot of that was through the passing game.
And partner, as a former defensive back, I'm having almost a physical reaction watching what's happening right now. But let's give credit where it's due, because they've done an excellent job moving the ball through the air. Secondary getting picked apart pass by pass. Obviously, they need to make some adjustments there on the back end.
Yeah, because offensively, we know that they're not going to be shy about throwing that football.
Now a pass hauled in downfield. And they're going to have this across midfield and inside the 45.
Forget about matriculating the ball down the field at this point of the game. They needed a big chunk, and they got one. And now, you're one completion away from giving your kicker a chance to win the game.
Plenty of time and two timeouts still at their disposal. First and 10 here.
Barkley inside handoff.
And a good push up front, and he's able to navigate his way down inside the 30. Here's first and 10.
They'll go to Barkley again. And he'll manage to pick up about 4. It's second down. Now a timeout called for by the defense as they'll get it with just a shade under a minute to go in the game.
Oh, fine work there as he gets this thing down to the 11-yard line.
Ravens going to use their third and final timeout. And as the two teams talk it over on their respective sidelines, we take a break. Up the middle with Barkley. And he'll be brought down this time at the 5-yard line.
And they picked up a little bit of yardage there. And now, in this situation, should be in no hurry to run a play really fast. Let the clock wind down.
On second down, here's Barkley. And that's a touchdown as they've broken our tie here in the final minute of the fourth.
The Baltimore offense at the line, set to get going. We have seen a lot of points here in this quarter. For us up here in the booth, it's been fun to watch. The defensive coordinators probably scratching their heads.
Yeah, they're going a little bit crazy right now. But let's face it, all our friends who play fantasy, they're enjoying the heck out of this show because most of them are creating and getting a bunch of points.
Yeah, points certainly not at a premium here. They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. So after all of this, it comes down to one final play.
And just think of what it's going to be, because from this distance, you've got to be prepared for everything. Hook and laterals, tip balls, you name it. A lot of laterals after a catch. Just got to be prepared, stand your feet defensively, and tackle someone.
Well, it took us until the final play chart to officially decide a winner, although on that last play, they were so backed up, it would have taken a miracle, and they couldn't get that miracle done.
Well, I like how you stayed with it, because we both knew that this had to go down to the last play, and neither side was going to exhale until that play concluded, because we've seen the improbable before. A couple of laterals, maybe some poor defense on the back end. They might have gone all the way to the end zone. In this case, though, it didn't happen. Perhaps next time.